farmers in the valley stop to do that, I have, of course, a benefit in the short run, a benefit in the long run. That is the best situation. Then all the others stop except than me, because I have the benefit today and benefit tomorrow. And this is the ideal situation for the so-called free riding opportunism, that I'm the only one to profit from the situation, the other take the cost and take the whole benefit. Okay, this is the, it's much easier to see that in a table. Anne and Bruno are the two farmers, two you can imagine, 20, 2000, is not important. What is important is myself and the others. Okay, if they both limits, three each, three for Anna, three for Bruno. The first number is the so-called raw player, and the current player is the second payoff. Then if they both limit three each. If they both don't limit, sorry, there's no limit, this is no limit there, I don't know why disappeared, because there was the conversion from Mac to PowerPoint, that something went wrong, but no problem. Limit, no limit, limit, no limit. If you have a pen, I can add here.
Oh, no, thanks.
No, because it's red. The reason is that the color is...
Oh, it's the color. So
yeah. Red.
Actually, it's not perfect, but no limit is there, okay? The fate, you have to believe in what you don't see, is typical of the fate experience. Theology, no?
Yeah.
Then, if they both don't limit to each, okay? Can you follow me? It's difficult, no, of course. At your age, everything is possible. To each. No, this is true. I think the most, just by the way, I think the most suitable, the perfect moment for teaching something complex to people is when they are between 16 and 17, because the brain is the most open moment in life. No?
This is true. Yeah.
Everything is possible, but if they will, because if they are sending some WhatsApp message, is very difficult to learn. Okay, to each. Anna no limit, doesn't limit, whereas Bruno limits, for Anna 4, for Bruno 1. Okay? And the other way around, in the opposite case. When Bruno doesn't limit, and Anna limits. Yes. Then 3-3, 2-2, 4-1, 1-4. It's not 1,4, it's 1 for Bruno and 4 for Anna, and vice versa. Okay, now I try to explain the same issue, the same game, with another language, but it's actually the same. This is called just another representation of the same game. Okay, Anna has two possibilities. She can limit or non limit. Okay? Bruno doesn't know what Anna does, because it's a simultaneous choice. Then, if Anna limits, Bruno will be here. If Anna doesn't limit, Bruno will be here. There is a so called imperfect information game. You don't know what will be your position, because it depends on what Anna does. Then there are two possibilities. Anna can limit or don't limit, okay? If Anna limits, Bruno is here. If Anna doesn't limit, Bruno is here. Bruno, in this round, can limit himself or don't limit himself. Okay? This is possible, always. And in case that Anna doesn't limit herself, Bruno is in the bottom line, is here. But for Bruno, it's always possible to choose between limit and no limit, limit and no limit, independently from what Anna does. Then Bruno, what Bruno will do? Bruno will say, okay, let's imagine first that Anna limits herself. Then Bruno will be in this part of the tree, so-called tree. Okay, if Anna limits, Bruno limits 3 points each. Why I put the red and the blue? You cannot see that, but the computer is very clear. Because one is the red is the payoff of Bruno, and the blue is the payoff of Anna. Anyway, if Anna limits, Bruno limits 3 points each. According to you, which is the payoff here? Who has an idea of that? Please?
Bruno gets 4 and Anna gets 1.
Okay, good. This is the situation in the higher part of the tree. And then let's go to the other possibility, because Bruno can say, okay, in this case, which is the choice of Bruno? She say, okay, if I don't limit myself, I get 4. If I limit, I get 3. I don't limit, because 4 is more than 3. Okay, this is the hypothesis. People want more than less. But let's imagine now the case where Bruno say, okay, let's imagine that Anna doesn't limit. What do we put here? That means Anna no limit and Bruno limits. Who has an idea? The other one, please. Yes.
1-4.
1-4? 1-4 for whom?
1 for Bruno and 1 for
Anna. 1 for Bruno and 4 for Anna. Yes. Good. And the last, yes, your teacher is very happy because he's very proud of you.
Yeah, I am.
Now, one lady, one girl, one lady. Which kind of payoff we expect for here? 2-2. Let's see. Yes. Okay. Which is, in this case, the choice of Bruno? Bruno will say, okay, if I limit myself, I get 1. If I don't limit, I get 2. 2 is more than 1, I prefer F. Which is the solution of this game? That independently from what Anna does, for Bruno, in both cases, is better no limit. Okay? Because in this case, 4 is more than 3, and in this case, 2 is more than 1. In any case, for Bruno, it's rational to limit himself. Then Bruno doesn't limit the consumption. Anna is like Bruno, you can reverse the reasoning. And then the solution of the game, as we said, we called it the Nash equilibrium, is 2-2. They don't limit themselves, and they destroy the field. This is the tragedy of the contents. There is an incentive to consume too much the content. Because we show that from the rational point of view, for the idea of rationality we have in economics, we consume too much the atmosphere, the environment, the tendency, just if you see just your payoff, and we see our payoff individually, we destroy most of the commons. It's clear why the tragedy of the commons, why is a tragedy? Because it's not a very good solution. If the equilibrium of the game is 2-2, that means we don't limit our consumption and we consume all the grass up to the end. Any question to this point? You are very quiet. This part of the room. Any question? Everything is clear. You are typical Dutch people with blonde hair. It's my first. Is my first class in a Dutch high school. I'm quite excited. Let's go ahead. Maybe. Okay. Just make an example. Just make a rehearsal. Can you? There is a volunteer among you that can spray again why for Bruno is rational to play no limits using the please can.
Please,
you must be very careful when you
Okay, no
try to speak very
What I think is, in any case, is the outcomes, the possible outcomes, is individually for the person itself. Let's say right now it's you, Bruno. It would be more beneficial for you to choose not to limit in any cases because you will have. More points in the end.
Okay. Just try to. Let's imagine you are me. It's not easy for you this imagination, but if you were me, just to expect your friends this game. Okay. Let's go. Limits. Please talk.
Yeah. Let's say I'm Bruno. And
yes.
Let's say I'm Bruno and Dan. If he limits, this is the option that we're going to right now. If I limit myself to, I get 2 points. So
no. Limits. How many points?
I'm sorry. Three. And if I do not limit myself, it will go to 1-4. But because he limits himself.
If final limits, you don't limit Bruno. How many points you get as Bruno?
1 second.
Ik
wil dat jullie de acte opletten. Blijf even gewoon erbij, jongens.
Ice Bruno will get 4 and Anne here gets 1.
Okay, good. And then conclude the explanation.
It will just if Anne here limits itself, limits himself.
Anna doesn't leave it because we are now in
the one pot. Okay, then if I limit and he does not, then I will get 1 and he will get 4.
Okay, and finally, common limitation?
2-2.
Brava. Congratulations.
Depending from...
She continues, yeah. Good. What's your name?
Which one?
Okay. Okay. Let's go ahead. Short version. Short version. Beautiful. Okay. Then no limit is the solution. But then.
Okay, we continue.
Okay, we continue. Just a few minutes and we go to the end. Conclude because the most exciting moment will be the second part of the class is the summer workshop.
Yeah.
Okay, the question. If we don't do anything special, we consume too much our commons, which have been the solutions along the history of humanity. Why we are able sometimes to not destroy commons, in particular in the Netherlands, you keep a very very clear your park, you keep clear your schools are very actually it's very impressive to see how your school is kept well clean. Why is possible to not destroy our commons? There are some possibilities. I will show you 3 standard possibilities. The first is so-called the social contract. The social contract is the Thomas Hobbes, maybe some of you one day we study a bit of philosophy, Jean-Jacques Rousseau, John Locke, all these people. Grotius, de Grot, was a Dutch important scholar of that. Althusius, there are a lot of people in between the 16th and the 17th century theorizing. Why? Because Europe was in the middle of a lot of wars. And then how is possible to make a peace, to make a peaceful life? The solution was, okay, if we don't do anything, we destroy ourselves, the war. You have to imagine a solution, social contract, which is in our table. The social contract, the old books, beautiful, brilliant minds, Thomas Hobbes, Rousseau, we translate all this stuff in -2. What does it mean? If we are able to create a fine police, the Leviathan, upset, sort of the authority that applies fine or sanctions to people that don't limit themselves, the structure of the payoffs, of the rewards of the game of life will change. Then we have, if I don't limit myself, I take 4 minus 2. If I don't limit myself, I take, say, 4 minus 2. Here is not 2, 2, but 2 minus 2 and 2 minus 2, 0, 0. And then you can see that in that case, the solution of the game will be cooperation, limit limits. If there are sort of policemen or the authority applying fines to people that pollute, the people that bring too much cattle to the field, then the rational solution of the game is 3-3. That is the standard solution when we are able to make a contract, to make pact, to make with some authority applying fine. But just one question. I don't know if you are following now the debate about Donald Trump's idea to go back from the Paris, you know, this Paris agreement about the climate change. He said, I'm America, I'm the boss, I don't respect that agreement, because it's very difficult for some global commons to create a sort of